Hi, this is Sean. In this video, we're going to go over rigid bodies and integrating them with keyframed animation. So, let's get started. I'm going to make a polysphere. And we've already talked about optimization and mixing these in with optimized proxy objects. But for this video, I'm just going to quickly go through and make just use the sphere itself as the collision object. And I'm going to bring this up. We'll make the sphere the dynamic collision object, and we'll make a plane the static object. So we're going to make that the passive object. And the sphere is the active object. And I'm going to turn off the grid. And so now, if we look at the properties and we've turned on the shape node, we can see that we've got a rigid body right in here. So before we can make this object work with keyframes, well, one of the probably the easiest way to deal with this is to group the object to itself. And that sort of generates an additional node where you can put some keyframed animation. And by default, the rotation or the rotation axis goes to the point of origin, so we're going to just quickly center that pivot point. And so now we're all good. And I'm going to, before I start working on this, right now the objects, it makes it easier. There's two nodes that are created when you make the rigid solver. There's the rigid solver node, and then there's also the rigid body node. And two properties that we're going to have to deal with are the active property, and then in the rigid solver, when you're working on your keyframe animation, you probably just want to turn the state to off. So one is on and two is zero is off here. So so there we go. So now let's create an initial trajectory for this object. Let's give ourselves a little bit more, a few more frames. And I'm going to set a keyframe on the group node. So I select the group node, or I could hit the up arrow, hit S. And I'm going to move us to 15 frames. S again, so now we can see that that's moving. But before I switch and set animation keyframes to go into dynamics mode, let's take a look at those keyframes. Under Window, Animation Editors, Graph Editor. By default, Maya has ease-ins set on the animation curves, which when you're transitioning to a dynamic system, you usually don't want to see your object slowing or easing into something, because then it'll go to a constant speed when it hands off to the dynamic properties. So it's usually good to just set those tangents to linear. It'll look a lot better. So now we've got that set. Let's go into the rigid body systems and let's just review. We've set keyframes on 14, it looks like. And so what we need to do is we'll set, go back. First of all, we're going to turn the rigid solver on. So let's go back to the state, turn that on, and let's set some keyframed animation for the active. So we'll set the active to off until frame 15. So we'll just key that. Go one more frame in, key it on. So let's rewind. Great. So now what's going on is we probably need to move this plane down a little bit. It just seems like we're not getting Yeah, there we go. The handoff to the dynamics object. The object is passing through the plane before it transitions back to being a dynamic object, and that's one thing you need to be careful for. But that's basically, in a nutshell, how to keyframe and handoff between dynamic objects. So thanks so much for watching.